Hey everybody, this is Luke from Speedcast.
So Starlink is primarily an internet-only service. So what we're gonna do now is we're gonna leverage our SIGMA net device. This is one of Speedcast's products. And this device lets you take your corporate network and you can run VLANs on this. You can forward ports so that you can access devices on your remote site. It's got firewalling capabilities, crew Wi-Fi, telephony. All of that is built into this box right here.
All right, so the next thing I want to show you is some things in our SIGMA port. So you can see it's got each of the six Ethernet ports on the SIGMA device. Number six here is not being used and neither is number three, but we've got one and two are for the Starlink starboard and port side. Number four is for our Starlink crew. That's what I've got the little Wi-Fi access point here connected to. And then my laptop is connected to the Starlink ops port, so the fifth port here. Next, I wanna show you a feature called remote access. So let's say that you've got devices just like this little travel router here. You need to be able to get to on your remote site to make changes to them, you know, edit configurations, debug things, see what's going on. SIGMA gives you a very easy way to do that. So let's start with the one that's on the WAN side here. So this is our Starlink port side system. And I want to get to the HTTP port on this particular router. So I'm gonna click connect here. And this has brought up the router configuration page for this router running DDWRT. If I wanted to go in through Telnet, I could do that too. So it's gonna bring up this interface and I can log in to the Telnet prompt. And again, this is happening. You don't even have to be on the ship. You don't have to be on the same connection. You could be anywhere in the world and we will tunnel all of this through straight to your SIGMA device. Let's say that I wanna get to this little travel router here. I'm gonna use SSH in this case. So I'm gonna hit the connect button on that and I can log in there as well. There you go. And now I'm into the travel router.
So let's say that you've got some equipment on your ship that's not using SSH or HTTP or Telnet, none of these standard protocols, and you still want to be able to reach that equipment through some type of proprietary protocol. We've got options to be able to do that too. So basically you would just add a port forwarding rule in our port forwarding module here. So you click add port forwarding rule, give it a name, choose the source. It's, you know, maybe it's only coming in on one of the links, or it could be coming on and from any source, TCP, you give it a port number or the incoming port, select which network interface it's going out over, say what the target IP address is of the device you want to send it to. And then in this case, we're using a database, so it's port 3306. You can choose from any of these remote tools, but in this case, it's none of those. And then you would click add port forwarding.
So one of the main use cases of SIGMA is if you want to provide internet access to your crew. And that can come along with certain restrictions that you may want to implement. You may want to treat different users differently, or even which of your connections you're using. For example, if you're using a 5G connection that's metered and you've only got a certain amount of allocated bandwidth, you probably don't want your crew to be using up all of that connection. However, if you're on Starlink where it's not metered, and you've got a nice big fast connection, you might want to let them go with no restrictions at all. Once you've done that, we also give you this nice dashboard to be able to see what you've used. Our SIGMA Universal Remote takes these broadband type of connections and turns them into a fully managed business service. It also lets us utilize multiple transmission paths to be able to keep our customers fully connected and fully supported at all times.